Well, some great fights in 1997, especially at the lighter weight. The one I've chosen is Spencer Oliver against Patrick Mullins for the Southern Area Super Bantamweight Championship. It was in February in Cheshunt, a great atmosphere ringside with Spencer, the Omen Oliver's fans. Patrick Mullins, a big danger though, two unbeaten fighters coming together. Both have gone on to have great years. Spencer has won the European Super Bantamweight Championship and Patrick Mullins has won the WBC International title. But this is when they were both unbeaten and everything to go for.
Well, this could be a cracking contest between the much-hyped Spencer Oliver in the white trunks, who calls himself the Omen, and Patrick Mullings from Harrow, who is also unbeaten. These two have sold an awful lot of tickets for tonight's show, particularly Oliver, whose PR people were throwing out red hats with the Omen written on them before the start of the fight here. Oliver, the Commonwealth Games silver medalist in 1994. Mullings, a former ABA bantamweight champion. Two prospects meeting in a crossroads fight. The singing is for Oliver. Mullings has had a quieter kind of build-up. He's a southpaw, decent movement and southpaw jab, less hyped than Spencer Oliver, who comes from Barnet, not very far at all from here. Oliver, remember, in the white trunks. This could be good, Glenn.
Well, certainly on paper, it has the makings of a very good fight. And they normally are when you get two unbeaten young prospects coming together. I think they're both so keen to win. It means so much to each of them. You're guaranteed a good fight.
Oliver has 9 out of 9 wins. Mullings has 10 out of 10. But the bigger stoppage percentage so far for Oliver, who got him with a very good right hand there. And again, then a left as well. Mullings under the sort of pressure he hasn't had to face so far in his career. So far they've usually just put him in with journeymen, the kind of capable fighters who put up a show but are usually beaten. Oliver really means business. Managed by Jess Harding.
Well, Mullins has thrown some fast punches, but certainly Oliver has got through with the more substantial punches.
Oliver looking busy and workmanlike in this opening round. Got through with some decent shots. And Mullings on the back foot, trying to counter. The right hand goes through again. Then the body shots. Oh, that's a great right uppercut, though, as they worked in close from Mullings. Easily his most eye-catching punch so far. That was a reminder to Oliver not to take too many liberties on the way in.
Yes, and that was stylish, classy work there from both boxers, but I think who just come out the stronger of it was Mullins with a good, classy right uppercut.
But I think this has been Oliver's opening round. Third round. Both unbeaten, as we've been saying, though Oliver has been on the floor once against the Scottish bantamweight Sean Anderson just over a year ago. But he got up to win that in the third round. This is the Southern Area Super Bantamweight Championship they're fighting for, the 8-stone, 10-pound division. The British Championship at the moment is vacant, soon to be contested by the excellent Michael Brody and the Welsh Neil Swain. Richie Wenton, no longer the champion. Again, the flashy counters from Mullings, but the heavier-looking punches from Oliver. The pattern is set, isn't it?
Yes, it is, just looking as if Oliver's just the heavier puncher of the two, but certainly Mullings coming back with some very good-looking combinations, and this really is a very good matchup.
Which of these two fine young fighters will prove to be the better. Left hand seemed to trouble Mullings there. Straight right through the middle as well. He's under heavy pressure, Mullings. And at the moment, no counters, just covering. Well, Oliver is looking the business here so far.
He's looking really, really good. He's got a good style, rolls into his punches nice. Very busy, very exciting. But Mullins shown he's got a few skills himself and he's coming back to contest this round very well indeed.
Mullings has proved that he's got a good chin already. Good punch resistance. He's taken these punches and he's come back with blows of his own. But he's really got a good variety about him. Big straight rights through the middle, hooks to the body as well. Mullings is under severe pressure. Richie Davis, the referee, takes a closer look. Mullings at last gets himself out of the trap.
Well, Mullings in danger of just leaving himself on the ropes just a little bit too long. I don't think he was really badly hurt there, but he's standing on the ropes, taking too many punches, and the referee was having a good close look there.
Some really impressive attacks from Spencer Oliver. He's got a good repertoire. Mullings isn't out of this just yet, but that's Oliver's round yet again.
Well, I think this fight is really living up to every expectation. It looked a great fight on paper between two young, unbeaten fighters.
He's only 21 as well, this Spencer Oliver.
He's very young. He certainly looks as if he has a very good future. Look, he's gritting his teeth. They're really looking for the shots. He's not just flaying away in there. He's looking for the openings. He's picking them from body to head, putting punches up the middle. Look at that, good body punches. Do you see Mullins try to come there with the uppercut? Oliver just slipped out of the way. And then starts to plant them again in the body and really working Mullings over at this point.
Great atmosphere as well for this contest, which is only giving it a more exciting feel. The white trunks of Oliver, who's been on the attack so far, but Mullings has got fast hands and flashy skills, and he's proved himself to have a decent chin. He doesn't believe that his resistance has been cracked yet. There's more for Oliver to do. Spencer Oliver, who used to spar in his front room with his brother Danny before they went off to the gym together. Young fighter who's grew up with a boyhood hero of Marvin Hagler, and you can't get much more of a hero than that to model yourself on.
Nice little counters from Mullings to remind Oliver he's still there.
Can Mullings claw his way back? Might there just be a little bit of a danger maybe for Oliver that he gets punched out, that he starts to fade a little? No sign of it so far. He's obviously really in absolutely tip-top condition for this. They both are, obviously, but we've been saying they're both young fighters. Glenn Mullings is, in fact, 26.
Yes, he's 26. You'd expect him to be the stronger and more mature of the two, but certainly he's looking very strong, Spencer Oliver. But there's still a ways to go yet, and Oliver's never been beyond six rounds.
This is good stuff now from Mullings. His best little spell for a while, but look at Oliver's answer to it. Well, it's a cracker, isn't it? Superb work, particularly with the uppercut by Oliver. But then Mullings produces something of the same.
And then you see work like this from much more accomplished and experienced fighters. This is very good work for someone so young.
Two men who both want this victory so very badly.
Watch your hands, come on!
He's got a good array of shots, hasn't he, Oliver?
He mixes them well, but Mullins, you know, I think, you know, he's a very classy fighter himself. He can mix them up, he can change them around. He's really testing Oliver as much as he can in there.
And a nice loose kind of rhythm about him as well, Mullings. Almost like an American fighter in style, isn't he? More than your sort of stand-up British type.
Yes, and what I like about these two young men is they're prepared to stand. There's not a lot of holding. They're looking for clean shots all the time. It's an excellent contest.
We go into this fifth round. Glenn McCrory has given everything so far to Spencer Oliver. I was a little kinder to Mullings in that last round, just giving him a share of that one. But Oliver will be ahead. The 21-year-old from Barnet in the white trunks. Mullings from not too very far away in Harrow, trained by Dean Powell. Oliver still mixing them up to head and body. Some really eye-catching shots to the rib cage and then uppercut, straight right. But Mullings, full of defiance still.
He really is. They're both mixing their punches up very well indeed. But again, you just sense that Oliver punching a little bit harder.
Certainly not broken the spirit of Mullings yet, though.
No, and although I'm giving these rounds to Oliver, they're all very close, and Mullings acquitting himself very well.
Toe-to-toe exchanges. Setting himself for these shots, Oliver. Doing more of the work still. That's a really good left hand. That must have hurt Mullings and shaken him a little. He seems to have absorbed everything so far. Well, he's thrown so much, Oliver, done so much work in the early stages of the contest. He's never been beyond six rounds before. One scenario just might be that Mullings may take all this and come on a bit stronger later on. You've seen that happen before.
Well, that could well happen, but this is really testing the resilience of Mullings, because he's had to take some good solid shots, both the body and head, and he's still there and still kicking them. But you feel these shots have got to start having an effect.
I was just thinking the same thing, Glenn. You can't continue, surely, to keep taking those punches and still be as fresh as a daisy in there. Oliver with friends, family, fans packing the arena. Good left again. Mullings just left himself a bit open to that. Then the right driven through the middle.
Again, he's showing a terrific array of punches, Oliver.
Big left hook from Oliver and then a countering right from Mullings. Almost after the bell. But it's that kind of contest.
Look at that. I mean, just a young man there just switching the jab into an uppercut and finding a gap through the middle of a good guard from Mullings. This is right at the end of the round where they didn't really want to finish fighting here. They're enjoying it and good work in there.
Seventh round. This is new ground for Spencer Oliver. He's never had to fight this far before.
And these two are throwing that many punches. I'm glad I'm not counting them in.
You'd need really fast fingers, wouldn't you? Bob Mee is the man sitting alongside us doing the job. Good right again that was by Oliver.
Mullins come back with a nice little left of his own. He's trying to push forward a little more, Mullins. Maybe he senses Oliver's just starting to tire.
Well, I suppose there has to be a question mark over the stamina of Spencer Oliver at this stage, since we've never seen him go this far before. But there's no sign of him letting up, certainly, yet. Digging in these body shots, Mullings now.
Yes, he's looking a little stronger in this round. He's keeping himself nice and compact, looking to try and get a bit of weight into his punches and look to try and switch them to the body.
Mullings just starting to force Oliver back for the first time. Starting to pick up the pace. Are we just seeing a little turning of the tide here in the seventh round?
I think certainly this is the best success for Mullings this far.
Mullings has soaked up everything Oliver can throw at him, but he's still there.
But Oliver quickly changes it around, puts Mullings on the back foot, starts to land the head and body again.
That's a good shot again by Oliver.
Just dipping the head there, Mullins. I'm not sure if he was hurt with the body punch.
Well, it's a terrific fight. Two big hooks going in there from Oliver. But Mullings still snarling defiance. Just look at this. This is some round, isn't it? Furious exchanges.
And Mullins maybe sensing a little weakness in Oliver now and going for broke with a couple of big punches.
What a fight this is.
This is tremendous work from both boxers. You see Oliver just pushing Mullins back here, but Mullins came back very well. I think it could have been Mullins' round. He was looking strong at the end. Maybe he feels, you know, he's took Oliver's best shots. And he's going for broke now.
Yeah, I thought Mullings just about did enough in that round. Particularly in the early part of the round and then late on again. Two rounds to go. Oliver in white, remember, in this important crossroads fight for these two hitherto unbeaten fighters. And at the moment, the omens look good for the omen, Spencer Oliver. Good work again.
Yes, Ian, very, very classy punches. And this is not a trial horse or a novice or journeyman he's in with here. He's in with an unbeaten, very good prospect, and he's shown quality moves like this.
It's an exciting talent for manager Jess Harding to have. He may really be able to make some waves with this young fellow. He's still got work to do here.
Yes, he has. I must say I've been very impressed with Patrick Mullings as well. He certainly have a good prospect. He's worked well, just been beaten to the punch a little by Spencer Oliver, but certainly put a very good account of himself.
I wonder what price these two meet again someday for some elevated title, not the Southern Area Championship, maybe the British title.
Well, I'm sure everybody in this hall would pay to see it again.
He's still doing good work, Mullings, here. And it's only the quality of Oliver's performance, really, which has got him behind on the scorecards. This has not been a bad performance at all by Mullings, but he's up against an exceptional young fighter in this Spencer Oliver.
Oh, Well, we've heard rave reviews about Spencer Oliver. They've talked about world titles, but certainly he has tremendous potential.
I'd like to see, I must say, a fight between Spencer Oliver and Michael Brody, the other brilliant prospect. What a fight that would be down the road.
Certainly a tremendous fight that's out there, and certainly the way they're going will probably happen. But Mullins isn't finished yet.
Really excellent cluster of punches to the head from Oliver. And what's really impressed me is the way that he's switched styles and still looks effective, working this new style of dancing around the edge of the ropes, getting in range, throwing clusters, getting away again.
Well, I think if you've won a silver medal in the Commonwealth Games, you've got to be able to box on the retreat as well.
What a pity he didn't get to box at the Olympic Games.
Mullins is coming forward, putting a great account of himself. You know, I can't give anything but praise to Patrick Mullins. You see some good work there, but just such a classy performance from Spencer Oliver.
Well, he's only 21, and if he wins this, it will be 10 out of 10. He'll have his first championship as well. Last round coming up. Both Glenn and I have Spencer Oliver in the white trunks in a pretty big lead. I have him 3 points ahead at this stage, so too does Glenn. If that's right, Mullings, of course, needs the knockout or stoppage. Frank Maloney, the manager of Patrick Mullings, is on his feet on the far side, and so too is Jess Harding, the manager of Oliver. Both of them living every second of it. It has been very good to watch this one.
It really has, and as well as great action, it's been such a good technical fight. You know, there's hardly been a clinch. They've done so very little wrong. It's been impressive all the way. Good mixture of punches. And good clean work throughout.
And a privilege really to report a fight as good as this between two excellent up-and-coming British fighters.
And Oliver's got a cut on the left eye and it looks quite bad there.
Suddenly that's opened up, hasn't it? It's probably too late to matter. Mullings gets in another two rights, and then body shots as well. He's going for it, Mullings. He knows he needs something sensational in this last round. More right hands going in, but there's only a minute and 20 seconds now remaining. That's a big right, and it hurt Mullings. He was staggered by that, Mullings. Probably more than any other punch in the contest. Could have been because he's got very tired. Is Oliver going to take him out here? Even with the cut. Mullings is stopped. With 53 seconds, it looked like, at the round remaining. But what a finish that was. Spencer Oliver. Horrible gash by the eye at the start of the round, and then coming back with the punches to force the stoppage.
Spencer Oliver is a great, great prospect. He showed some great work here. He was badly cut, landed a good punch and just piled it all on here. You know, he really went for broke. And you know, a real character, a real good fighter, so much to offer.
He was halfway outside the ring when referee Richie Davis stepped in to stop it.
Some good right hands going in there from Oliver.
Ladies and gentlemen, 2 minutes and 8 seconds of the 10th and final round, with Mullins in no position to continue. Your winner and the new Southern Area Super Bantamweight Champion, Spencer the Omen Oliver.